गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? यस, आई एम फाइन एंड आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर फाइन. यस, इन द लास्ट क्लास आई हैव टॉट यू अबाउट रीजन्स ऑफ द अर्थ. ओके, सो इन दिस क्लास आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन द क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर ऑफ द सेकेंड चैप्टर, दैट इज regions of the earth. So take your notebooks and write down question and answers of second lessons. Okay, so don't be get confused. I will explain each question twice. Okay, so open your textbook and also notebook. Okay, so write down heading as unit 2, regions of the earth, and subheading is temperature zones. Yes, temperature zones. Next, write down first question is there. Answer the following questions. This is the first main question. Answer the following questions. Over. Okay, among them, write down a question is there. First question is there. List the factors that influence the climate of a place. Yes, list the factors that influence the climate of a place. Okay, write down answer. The factors that influence the climate of a place, the factors that influence the climate of a place. So first is latitude, 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 in the bracket, distance from the equator. Okay, yes, next, second point is altitude. Third point is distance from the sea. And fourth one is humidity. Yes, fourth one is humidity. And fifth one is winds. So these are the factors that influence the climate of a place. Okay, over, fine. Okay, shall we move for next question? Okay, so write down B1 question is there. Define the term altitude. So right answer, altitude is a height of a place above sea level. Altitude is a height of a place above sea level. Over. So write down third question. Yes, what is humidity? Question mark. Let continuously. What is the effect of high humidity? Yes, write down answer. Humidity is the amount of moisture or water vapor in the air. Yes, humidity is the amount of moisture or water vapor in the air. We tend to perspire a lot when the humidity is high. Yes, we tend to perspire a lot when the humidity is high. Yes, Stop. Fourth question is, how do winds influence the climate of a place? So write down answer. So first one is, the direction of winds at a particulate place also determines its climate. Stop. So write down second one point. Winds can be hot, cold or moist depending on where they originate. Yes. Winds can be hot, cold or moist depending on where they originate. Yes. Third point is, winds blowing from oceans and seas are cool and moisture laden. Fourth point is, winds blowing from the desert area are hot and dry. So there are 4 points. So first one is, the direction of winds at a particulate place also determines its climate. Second point is, winds can be hot, cold or moist depending on where they originate. Third point is, winds blowing from oceans and seas are cool and moisture laden. Fourth point is, winds blowing from the desert area are hot and dry. So next, fifth question is, describe the temperate zone. So write down answer. The temperate zone lies in both the hemisphere. Yes, full stop. The north temperate zone lies between the Tropic of Cancer, that is 23.5 degrees north, and the Arctic Circle, yes, that is 66.5 degrees north. Yes. Next, the south temperate zone lies between the Tropic of Capricorn, 23.5 degrees south, and the Antarctic Circle, 66.5 degrees south. Next, the climate is temperate, neither too hot, nor too cold. As these regions receive slightly slanting rays of the sun. Okay. So write down sixth question. Life is difficult in the frigid zone. Give reasons, yes? Life is difficult in the frigid zone. Give reasons, yes. So write down answer. It is bitterly cold and low temperatures exist throughout the year. means it is bitterly cold and low temperatures exist throughout the year. Full stop. The land is permanently frozen near the poles. The land is permanently frozen near the poles, and therefore life is difficult in the frigid zone. Yes. Therefore, life is difficult in the frigid zone. Next, second one, main question is, that is, fill in the blanks. Fill in the blanks. Yes. So, first question is, places along the equator receives. Places along the equator receive dash rays of the sun. Yes, which types of rays? That is direct rays. Okay, so equator receives direct rays of sun. Write down direct, direct, direct. Okay, next, second one is, the place is located in the plains are. The places located in the plains are hotter than those which are located at higher altitude. Yes. So we have discussed about this. Okay. So the places located in the plains are hotter. HOTTER. Hotter than those which are located at higher altitude. Okay. Next, C1, that is third question is, the poles receive. Yes, the poles receive dashed rays of the sun. Yes. Which types of rays receives the poles? Yes, that is slanting. Okay. Slanting, SLANTING, slanting rays. Okay. Next, fourth one. In summer, the land heats up dash than the sea. Yes, faster. In summer, the land heats up faster than the sea. Next, fifth one. In winter, the land loses heat faster than water. In winter, the land loses heat faster than water. Okay, so write down fifth question. The south temperate zone lies between the yes, Tropic of Capricorn and the Antarctica Circle. Okay, Tropic of Capricorn and the Antarctica Circle. Next, the winds blowing from the Thar Desert are. Yes, the winds blowing from the Thar Desert are hot and dry. Yes, hot and dry, because that is a desert area. Yes, so therefore the winds are very hot. Next, last one is, the south frigid zone is mainly occupied by the continent of Antarctica. Yes, so Antarctica, it is a scientific continent. Yes. So over, next one is, third main question is, give reasons. Yes, we have to write reasons. Okay, so first one is, so write down first one, the heat is more concentrated at places along the equator. Yes, that is, why is the more heat on the equator. Yes, the heat is more concentrated at places along the equator. Yes, so write down regions along the equator receive direct rays of the sun and make them hot and humid. Full stop. The direct rays of the sun travel a shorter distance and cover a smaller area. So the heat is more concentrated at places along the equator. Yes. So next one is B1 question. Okay. The sun's rays become weak by the time they reach the poles. Yes. The sun's rays become weak by the time they reach the poles. Yes. So write down, as the earth is tilted on its axis, the poles receive slanting rays of the sun. The poles receive slanting rays of the sun. Full stop. The rays travel a far greater distance. The rays travel a far greater distance and become weak by the time they reach the poles. So what? So next one is, write down C1 question. Chennai is more humid than Ooty. Yes. So Chennai is more humid than Ooty. So write down answer. Places close to the sea have higher humidity. As the volume of water that evaporates is huge. As the volume of water that evaporates is huge. And places that are in the interior of a country are far less humid. So Chennai, located on the southeast coast. So Chennai, located on the southeast coast, is more humid than Ooty, which is in the interior of the country. So write down last question is there. Winds blowing from the Bay of Bengal are cool and moisture laden. Yes. Winds blowing from the Bay of Bengal are cool and moisture laden. So write down. So winds blowing from the Bay of Bengal became cool and moisture laden due to the vast water bodies. Okay. Winds blowing from the Bay of Bengal become cool and moisture laden due to the vast water bodies. Okay. So write down fourth question. That is, write T for true and F for wrong statement. That is false statement. Okay. So there are some statements, so we have to write for those statements that are true and F for false statements. Okay, so first one is the torrid zone is the hottest zone of the on earth. Yes, the torrid zone is the hottest zone on earth. Yes, it is true. Yes, write down true. Next, the Tropic of Capricorn passes through India. Yes, is this true? No. Yes, so you have to write false. Yes. Next, C1, the places along the equator have distinct summer and winter seasons. Yes, so false. Next, the word temperate means moderate. Yes, the word temperate means moderate, so true. Okay, next, the term fridge means extremely hot. The term fridge means extremely hot, so it is false. Fridge means cold. Yes. And next, last one is, in the temperate zone the days are longer during summer. Yes, in the temperate zone the days are longer during summer, so true. Okay, so this is all about question answer of that is regions of the earth. Okay, write very neatly, don't make any mistakes. Okay, so thank you for watching video.